Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name is Ryan Speck. Today we're going to be taking a look at the newest creation out of the Wildwood FSX factory. It's the 260 RT Toy Hauler. All right, one of the most important things to consider when you're buying a travel trailer is the weights, what your tow vehicle is capable of and what the trailer weighs. Now this guy comes in with a gross weight of 7,600 pounds, but that's allowing for about 2,700 pounds of cargo. The more important weight you want to pay attention to is the dry weight, which this particular trailer, just over 4,800 pounds. So pretty half ton towable little unit that we've got here. We're gonna go over some of the really cool features that Wildwood has packed into this little guy. It is not a huge toy hauler, but it can haul your huge toys. We'll go into some more details here in just a bit. First thing I want to point out as we look at the 260 RT, this is your campsite side. Look at the size of the windows you got on this thing. You're not going to be facing your neighbors and looking at their camp. You're going to be opened up right to your camp under a beautiful large power awning. Even has adjustable pitch, so if you're out on a rainy day, just come right over here to the side, adjust that pitch, and it'll shoot that water off one end. You can also even adjust both sides if the sun's going down over here, kind of extend your shade into the evening. Right behind me, you'll also see we do have outdoor speakers that'll play off your Bluetooth capable indoor sound system. This is a coax cable that's hooked up to your TV antenna, and there's power out here too, so you don't have to miss a Bronco game just because you're out camping with the family. Right up above, we got a big strip of LED lights, runs the full length of the awning. I really like the way Wildwood does this too. A lot of guys are putting that light strip on the outside of the awning, which means you have to have the awning out in order to use that LED light strip, which isn't always feasible here in Colorado or some of our neighboring states, as windy as it can be. As we continue to move along, one of my favorite things I just noticed they started doing, all your baggage doors are held open with magnets now instead of those little plastic clips that you forget about or tend to get brittle and break off. Spare tires stowed right in your pass-through storage, and look at that, that is a full pass-through storage area. Tons of room for easy up tents, camp chairs, all kinds of things that can go in there. Right up front, you've also got pre-wire for solar panels, so if that's something you decided to do, we sell them in our parts store anywhere from 40 to 160 watts. Plug them right in and keep a trickle charge on your battery. All right, as we continue around the front side to the driver's side of the trailer, we do bring it in with the power tongue jack on it. Also has a light, which is really important because you're not always hooking up in the middle of the day. Nice hard plastic cover for your propane tanks with a quick access right up above so you can reach in there. But we found here in Colorado at the altitude, those vinyl covers just don't last very long, so we always do the nice hard plastic cover. Of course, the other side to get into your pass-through storage here, again, it goes all the way through. Tons of room for storage. Both your dump valves, located in a great spot right up here in front of the axles, sitting up pretty high so you don't have to worry about getting torn off. Both your gray and black are right there. You also have a black tank flush for rinsing out your black tank or your toilet tank after you've dumped it to make sure that your sensors and stuff don't get all mucked up. Right here we got the backside of the refrigerator as well as the furnace, city water connection, as well as the fresh tank fill spot. And as we continue to rotate back, you'll see we've got the 6-gallon hot water heater. Does have a recovery rate of about 16.2 gallons per hour. And real quick, I want to glance up. Doesn't seem like a big deal, but this is actually the exhaust vent for your kitchen, so right above your cooktop. And a lot of makes will have a fan in there, but they don't actually vent it out, so it's really nice that Wildwood actually vents that out. And you got your power cord here as well. 30 amp service, just pulls right out, stows right in here as well, just makes it nice and convenient. And this guy can close up so you don't have to worry about any mud daubers or anything getting in there. Back here you've got a hookup, so if you're at a park that offered satellite or cable, or if you had a portable satellite or something with you, it hooks right there and it's piped into where your TV's hooked up. And then one of the coolest parts on any toy hauler is the party deck, but I don't know of anyone besides your big toy haulers, your wide body units, that are doing the party deck setup, but Wildwood is. So what we've got here, we lay this sucker down and it'll set up as a deck Then you've got a couple cotter pins to pull. Fold these guys up and boom, you've got a really nice, what they call the play pin in the industry. So you got one pin there to pull, one pin here to pull, and this guy will fold up and become a really nice party deck for you and your guests to kind of hang out on. And one of the cool features that Wildwood has given you this year, small, simple touches, but you've got the nice screen here, so you can keep this open. It velcros to the walls. You're not worrying about any of the bugs getting in. And there's a zipper right in the center, so you can kind of traverse in and out. You've also got pre-wiring for a backup camera or an observation camera if that's something you decided to do. And if you're anything like me, camping ain't quite the same without a cold beverage. So they've given you a really cool bottle opener right here on the party deck that you're probably gonna be hanging out on a lot. Come on inside, check out the Wildwood FSX 260 RT's interior. First thing you'll notice as you walk in, you've got really nice fit and finish in this one. So you've got hidden hinges on all your cabinetry doors. You've got nice, really nice wood flooring. You've got really nice roller blackout shades on all the windows, except by your cooktop, of course, because that does, fire code doesn't allow you, so they got the regular metal blinds there. You got a couple really good sized couches here, a huge table as well. I really like the way this table is too. It's a freestanding table. It doesn't set up on those poles, and instead of having to pull it out and fold your legs in, it literally just kind of hinges down into the position it needs to be. Then when it's time to load in the toys, what you'll do, and it'll be the same on either side. If it was me, I'd probably stick these up on the master bed up in the main bedroom. Just get these cushions out of your way, and it's pretty simple what happens from here. So imagine those up in that main bedroom. This will fold up and it will simply just kind of fold these legs in, and this guy will pin to the wall here, so you've got all the room that you need to load your toys in here. Got a leg on each side that'll fold up. And that's true on both sides. You've got tons of room in here. You can actually fit one of your four-seat Razors in here, one of the Can-Am Spiders, actually an Easy-Go, pretty good-sized golf cart can fit in here as well. Now we'll move on into the kitchen. One thing I really like about Wildwood, they do a good job of giving you a lot of 12-volt USB outlets. You have your regular 110 outlet here, but a 12-volt USB is nice. So if you're somewhere without hookups, you can still charge your devices and stuff. Pretty good-sized sink that you've got here. Nice double basin, plenty of room for pots, pans, all your silverware and stuff. And they give you this little bit of a sink cover to kind of extend that counter space for you. Real big storage. This shelf is removable in case you had some taller items that you had in here. And one thing I want to point out, if you look up in here, you'll notice this just isn't stapled together. Everything is actually screwed and glued together. Because you know, when you're going up and down the road, staples have a tendency to work themselves out. Plenty of storage here below. Nice big drawers. You've got some storage down to the side of the sink as well. Two burner stovetop. And again, I told you that this fan actually vents out. So you've got a fan here, and it's also got a light on it too. Above that, you've got your microwave. Right over here, you've got your gas electric Dometic refrigerator. So when you're somewhere without hookups, running it on propane, if you got hookups, go ahead and plug in and it'll automatically switch over and run on electricity. So now we're gonna take a look at the entertainment center, which is right by the entry door. First thing I'll mention is it does have the new HD antenna. Sits up on top like a mushroom, and this is just to aim it to pick up a better signal. On this lot, you pick up channels out of Cheyenne and Denver. That's how good that antenna is. Down here, you've got your built-in Bluetooth capable stereo. It's got some USB ports on it as well. Indoor and outdoor speakers that'll play off of it. All the controls for your power awning, some interior lights, your water heater and water pump are all right here, as well as the ability to read all your tank and battery levels. Above that here, you've got the hookup, one that's hooked up to your antenna and one that's hooked up to the port on the outside, the other coax, in case you had a satellite or you were at a park that offered cable. Pretty good storage down below as well. And then one of the neatest things, if you look all the way at the bottom, they also bring it in with the electric heater fireplace. That sucker is rated to heat 400 square feet. So if you're somewhere with hookups, you won't have a problem at all keeping this whole coach warm on electricity and not burning through your propane. One final thing I'll mention, since we are in a toy hauler, they do have the vent here for gas and tire smells. And there's one actually on the opposing side down below to kind of help draw that air out as you're headed down the road. So when you get to camp, you're not gonna have that gassy or tire smell here in your cargo area. All right, so the Wildwood 260 RT FSX is gonna have a really nice size bathroom. There's a pass-through bathroom that you go to get to the bedroom. First thing you'll notice as you look in here, you've got plenty of room around the stool that you're not gonna be banging your knees on the shower or the sink. Pretty good linen storage up above the stool as well. AC duct that runs in here. We also bring it in with a nice fan, so it'll help exhaust any of the smells in the bathroom. Really nice glass enclosure here on the shower. It actually magnets together to make sure all that water stays nice and tight in here. And then over here, you'll notice you've got a mirror as well as a good size sink for the bathroom. And then down below it, you've got some extra storage as well. So a really nice setup here in the Wildwood 260 RT's bathroom. All right, come on through the bathroom into the master bedroom here on the Wildwood FSX 260 RT. First thing you'll notice as you come in is you've got some really nice cabinetry. You've got two windows that oppose each other so you can actually get that cross ventilation. I really like this though. Your cabinet, they don't cut it short. It's actually a full length cabinet so you can actually hang decent sized clothes in here. They're not gonna be dragging on the bottom. Each side of the bed has got two USB ports that'll run off your 12 volt system as well as 110 outlet. Some storage up above the bed as well. Pretty good amount. Each one of these lights on the backside has its own individual button too, so if one of you wants to stay up and read a book or whatever, the other can roll over. This is a neat little touch that they've given to you though. So that pass-through storage is accessible from in here by lifting the bed up, but instead of just having a little bit of wasted space right at the foot, they give you a little area below, kind of a shoe nook to kick your shoes off, and some nice handy little storage bags as well. So even though we're not in a huge toy hauler, we have got all the features that you'd have in just about any toy hauler out there, and you can haul just about any toy on the market. Well, thanks for taking the time to spend with me here today at the Great Outdoors RV Company in Evans, Colorado, taking a look at the latest and greatest creation out of the FSX Wildwood factory. It's the 260 RT toy hauler. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to give us a call at 970-313-4337 or just drop me an email, ryan@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Looking for some closer, I'll tell you everybody's standing in a line for the water slide. Oh.